So here I am on my lofty open house carnivorous plants platform. I call it an open house because I don't have any roof or shelter above me. These plants are also elevated, so they get plenty of sunlight. You can see down here just how they're elevated. And they're being supported by this wooden platform. As a general rule, the more sunlight you give these plants, the healthier they will be. Now, talking about healthy plants, look at this beautiful Sarracenia Leucophylla. The form is called Red Veins. This is exactly the same plant that I had on my Facebook page a couple of weeks ago. I tell you what, I couldn't believe the response. When you look at these beautiful pictures, is there any wonder that this plant appeals to so many people? Now, of course, these pictures aren't flowers, even though they may look that way. They are in fact leaves, and they're very, very effective at catching all sorts of insects. Whoops, you almost fell in there. Every time I come up here, I always hear buzzing sounds coming out of these pitchers. Always puts a smile on my face because I know my plants are happily feeding. It definitely adds a whole new perspective to having carnivorous plants in your garden. Now, this pitcher over here, it's around about 65 centimeters high. That's the tallest pitcher. And you can see why North American pitcher plants really are beautiful to have in your garden, not only because of their colors, but because of their commanding presence with their high pitches. Sarracenia Leucophylla typically produce their best and biggest pitches in autumn. When I compare this early spring pitcher, this brown one over here, you can see how it's a lot smaller than the autumn pitcher. And that just highlights the fact that these Sarracenia Leucophylla peak around about autumn. You can see here how I've cut off these older pitchers. They were also formed in early spring. As those leaves get more brown, you can always cut them off a little bit lower. Over here you can see flat non-carnivorous leaves. These are called phyllodia. They're perfectly normal. Depending on your variety and species of North American pitcher plant, that will determine when these phyllodia are formed. Wow, look at this. Look how popular they are with insects. Amazing. I opened up one of my Sarracenia Leucophylla last year and they were absolutely packed full of flies. Yeah, it's just amazing. Now, let's go back to the base of this plant. I started off with two bare-rooted rhizomes, and I've noticed that the rhizomes have traveled in a certain direction. They've pretty much traveled across the pot here. So you can see there's plenty of room over here as well as over here. Even though there is space here, I'm still going to have to repot this plant, because actually I will have to repot it, because you can see here how the rhizome is hard up against the side of this pot. If I don't divide this plant or put into a bigger pot, when it starts to release new shoots in early spring, those shoots will start to form down here because there's no room for it, and that's the last thing I want. Now let's just zoom in here on this beautiful lush moss. Look how beautiful that is. Look how the color of this moss varies. So you've got this lush green here, not so green over here. Then of course here you have this older moss over here with its brown colored leaves. And nestled amongst that moss is this beautiful Drosera burmanni tropical sundew. And there's also one over here as well. Look at that, nestled amongst this older moss. It's always nice to see moss growing around your plants, the base of your plants. The moss also performs a very important function. It acts like a blanket. It keeps the water from evaporating too much out of the peat moss. That helps to keep the peat moss nice and damp, which helps to keep the roots of your plants nice and cool. That's especially important during those really hot days. And I might just go up to one of these pitchers and see whether we can hear some buzzing sounds coming out of the pitchers. Let's have a listen. Probably not today, but I tell you what, they do get absolutely packed full of flies. Anyway, this one won't be ready until I start to grow a few more, but I tell you what, you guys will be the first to know when they are available. So until then, happy growing.